notice.
It was really short notice, actually. We didn't even know till yesterday. How many veterans do I have in the audience? Raise your hands. Yeah, raise them proud. That's right. Thank you. Thank you very much for your service. Thank you all. I'm very, very proud to stand here and help represent 65,000 gay, lesbian, and bisexual service members that currently serve in our United States Armed Forces. For 12 years, I was very fortunate to be one of those service members that got to serve. I served as a paralegal and as an Army recruiter. And I was outed by a colleague's wife in my 12th year of service, which meant that I lost my retirement. Yeah, I say boo to that one too, because I'm perfectly qualified. I stand before you with a graduate degree from a top school, ready to serve my country. I'm fit, I'm ready, I'm able, and why can't I serve still? I know some people think that the day that I was outed was the day that I became gay, but I hate to tell them that I was gay long before that. And so I'm here today to say, call your member of Congress. Tomorrow is a key day. Tomorrow could be the day that we see the end of this discrimination in our armed services. It's up to every single one of us to pick up the phone and do what we can do. If you're too young to vote, talk to your parents. Tell them what you believe in, because this generation doesn't like this law. Thank you very, very much for having us. We are so appreciative of your support. And I know some of you came out to see Lady Gaga today. And I'm very proud to say that I've gotten to hold hands with her now. Now, I'm extremely honored to introduce our next guest speaker. She's a friend. She's your member of Congress. She has fought so hard in the House Armed Services Committee to get it through the House and get Don't Ask, Don't Tell to the floor of the House and get the repeal done in the House. Tomorrow in the Senate. I'm very proud to introduce the Honorable Shelley Pingree.
Ain't no country, Kobe.